South Korea's got a new weapon. The country displayed its Hyunmoo 5 surface-to-surface ballistic missile for the first time at a parade to mark the country's Armed Forces Day on the 1st of October. Images from the parade at Seoul Air Base in Songnam revealed two 9-axle transporter erector launcher, or TEL, vehicles carrying the new missiles. The military referred to the weapon as the ultra-high-power Hyunmoo ballistic missile. This is an interesting development. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how formidable is South Korea's new Hyunmoo 5 ballistic missile. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Hyunmoo 5 ballistic missile is primarily designed with North Korea in mind. South Korea's military views the Hyunmoo 5 ballistic missile as essential for deterring North Korean aggression and addressing nuclear threats. The Hyunmoo 5 was developed by South Korea's Agency for Defense Development in collaboration with Hanwha Aerospace. Unconfirmed news reports suggest that Hanwha Aerospace began production of the missile in late 2023 following a series of tests and evaluations. The Republic of Korea, or ROK, armed forces are likely planning to integrate the Hyunmoo 5 into their newly established Strategic Command Unit, which oversees the military's three-axis defense system. South Korea's three-axis system aims to defend its territory by developing a kill chain to preemptively strike the source of an attack, intercepting the incoming missiles using the Korea Air and Missile Defense, or KAMD, and employing the Korea Massive Punishment and Retaliation (KMPR) campaign to eliminate the adversary's command and control by neutralizing its leadership and military facilities. Dubbed a monster missile by South Korean media, the Hyunmoo 5 was tested successfully last year. Hyunmoo 5 is thought to be powered by a two-stage solid fuel engine and is estimated to have a length of about 16 meters and a diameter of 1.6 meters. The missile reportedly weighs 36 tons. To give viewers a perspective, American nuclear-tipped Minuteman III ICBM has a weight of 32 tons. The Hyunmoo 5 is categorized as short-range, but if topped with a 1-ton warhead, typical for ballistic missiles, its range can exceed 5,000 kilometers, or around 3,100 miles, according to Yoo Young-won, a lawmaker on South Korea's Parliamentary Defense Committee. When configured for a short-range target, the missile can carry a 9-ton warhead. The massive warhead could penetrate deeply buried bunkers, making it ideal for targeting North Korea's underground military sites, including command centers and missile silos. Viewers may note that North Korea's capital, Pyongyang, is located about 160 kilometers or 100 miles from the border with South Korea. The Hyunmoo 5 is equipped with a sophisticated inertial navigation system, or INS, enhanced by GPS corrections, providing exceptional accuracy over long distances. This makes it highly effective at striking strategic targets. The missile system also includes a range of flight control sensors, such as wind and atmospheric pressure detectors, that continuously adjust its trajectory in real time. Additionally, its design features stealth technologies integrated into the hull, making it more difficult for enemy radars to detect. Hyunmoo 5 ballistic missile uses a transporter erector launcher, or TEL. The TEL demonstrated impressive all-wheel steering capability in the published footage. It's to be noted that some of these missiles will be fired on-site from the various missile bases, but some of them will move out of the bases into other pre-planned spots for firing. Since the roads in the countryside, where most of the missile bases are located, are narrow and often have tight curves, a huge TEL like the Hyunmoo 5 TEL would need all the road maneuverability to move into their pre-planned spots. So this high-tech TEL is crucial as it enables flexibility in deployment and swift attack preparation. Military analysts in South Korea have praised the missile's cold launch system, which utilizes compressed gas for more stable launches. They've drawn comparisons to China's powerful Dongfeng 31 ICBM. The development of the Hyunmoo 5 system comes with substantial financial investment. The South Korean Ministry of National Defense has earmarked approximately $255 billion for military modernization between 2021 and 2025. A significant portion of this budget is focused on upgrading missile systems and advancing technologies. Specifically, the missile programs, including both the Hyunmoo 4 and Hyunmoo 5, are allocated around $1.2 billion, underscoring their crucial importance to national security. North Korea actually has made significant strides in military capabilities. The country, ruled by Kim Jong-un, successfully tested the Hwasong-18 ICBM three times in 2023, which can even target the U.S. mainland. The country is also developing nukes, so in the last few years, the threats from North Korea have elevated to a great extent. Since assuming office in 2022, South Korea's President Yoon Suk-yeol has reinstated the tradition of annual military parades as part of his peace through strength strategy. He's also supported strengthening military ties with the United States and fostering closer cooperation between Seoul, Washington, and Tokyo. This year's parade featured a U.S. B-1B strategic bomber flyover for the first time, along with participation from the U.S. 8th Army Band and an Armored Striker Brigade. President Yoon told thousands of troops who gathered at the base on Tuesday, "If North Korea attempts to use nuclear weapons, it will face the resolute and overwhelming response of our military and the South Korea-U.S. alliance. That day will be the end of the North Korean regime." Yoon said the North Korean regime must abandon the delusion that nuclear weapons will protect them. The missile's capability to target and destroy North Korea's underground bunkers makes it a powerful deterrent. According to South Korean media reports, in the event of a crisis, dozens of these missiles could be launched, potentially inflicting severe damage on Pyongyang. Key leadership and command centers could be neutralized within minutes, posing a critical threat to the regime.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.